The former editor of the News of the World could face jail after being charged over Britain's phone hacking scandal.
Rebekah Brooks says she's the victim of a witch hunt. Our Europe correspondent Brett Mason is in London. Brett, what are her former colleagues in the press saying?
Understandably, Bill, there is a huge interest in this story here in the United Kingdom. It is front page news this morning in every newspaper, except for one, The Sun. That is the newspaper Rebekah Brooks used to edit. This front page headline perhaps best summing up the developments. Fight said red, Rebekah Brooks vowing to clear her name when she fronts court.
Facing three criminal charges, but still clearly a friend of the force. Moments after police charged Rebekah Brooks with conspiring to pervert the course of justice, they rushed her through a back door to avoid the cameras. It would have worked had she not been driven down a dead-end street.
They can't get out.
Nothing more than an expensive sideshow, a waste of public money.
The former Sun and News of the World editor is accused of plotting with her husband Charlie to hide evidence from police at the height of the phone hacking scandal. It is also alleged Brooks and her long-term personal assistant Cheryl Carter destroyed seven boxes of material taken from the News International Archive. The company's head of security, Mark Hanna, a second security guard, and Miss Brooks's chauffeur have also been charged.
I have concluded that in relation to all suspects, there is sufficient evidence for there to be a realistic prospect of conviction.
I have grave reservations that my wife can ever get a fair trial.
I know that there needs to be a proper and thorough investigation. And I am baffled by the decision to charge me today.
An intriguing and salacious story which will no doubt be front page news when Miss Brooks and her five alleged accomplices face court on June 13.
50 people have been arrested since Scotland Yard reopened the phone hacking investigation. If convicted, Brooks and her five alleged accomplices face a maximum sentence of life behind bars.
Brett Mason, thank you.